Hello, everybody. It's Nancy Kelly, and I'm here with one of my tremendous students, Miss Vanessa Vacanti. Hi, Vanessa. How are you doing?
I'm doing well.
Thanks for stopping by today. Yeah. This is going to be really fun. We're just going to show everybody what we do at a lesson and, you know, what the process is that we go through. And we'll probably even start with some scales, just like we always do. Are you warmed up at all today? Did you happen to warm up before you came here?
Not car warm-ups.
Yeah, car. No car warm-ups now. I do the same thing. I do glissandos in the car. We know. I do those. I was just going to say, let's go back and do a few of the scales that we always use. I learned these from I borrowed these, I guess I should say, from a wonderful teacher in L.A., Seth Riggs. I suppose we shouldn't use his scales without mentioning his name. we'll do some mamas, okay? Beautiful. Where is your break note?
B natural.
You went over that like a queen. It was just absolutely gorgeous. Let me start and see if I can hear it. We'll start at A. Ready?
Ma 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 ma.
Beautiful.
Ma 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 ma.
So that's that spot. I mean, I don't have my third camera on, but that's that spot that some people often refer to as the second break. It's not talked about a lot. There's an area of the voice around D flat 5, E flat 6, right in that area. It's called the second break. And all that really means is you're only getting head voice. You're not getting any mix. You're not getting any chest voice at all, you know. Some people, you can actually hear the voice change a little bit in that area. So let's go back. Let's go back with our mamas, and we'll kind of cross over that area and see how you do with that. So, ready? Go ahead.
Ma 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 ma. Ma, 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 ma.
That was it. I can hear it. That my ear is so tuned to what you guys are doing. I can hear the change happen on that D flat. When you get to that area, this is when you need to really get under the note. What do I mean by get under the note?
With breath and support.
Support. What is support? What muscle in your body is giving the support?
The diaphragm.
And what other muscle? Core muscles.
Yes.
Core muscles. Well, there's two things that happen there when you're singing. So maybe you could explain to me or help us understand what happens when you breathe in, when you inhale for singing. Your diaphragm does what action?
It pulls down.
Yes, it pulls down and it literally sucks air into your lungs. It's really a pretty cool process. Doesn't take much fussing around to do it either. You know, when I first teach you guys this, I have you overdo it so that you learn it. I love that little the little visual of pouring water in a glass. I tell people this all the time because it's so relaxing just to think of pouring water in a glass and it fills from the bottom up. So when we're breathing, and especially for your scales, I want you to take a full breath. So you're going to ma 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 ma. So let's get back and do that. And on the top note, you're gonna give that a little extra oomph, okay?
Okay.
So we get a clear tone. Okay, let's go. Let's go at C and.
Ma 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 ma. Ma 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 ma.
a nay nay, and we'll hear that sound come forward. Nay 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 nay. Ready?
Nay 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 nay.
Beautiful. I love the vibrato. I love how you're letting your voice go into vibrato. Before you met me, you had some wonderful work with a teacher who was a classical teacher, and I just love the combination of these two disciplines, the way it's working on you. Because you're very interested in theater, but you're also very interested in singing jazz, and you've been out working and doing jazz. And we're gonna work on a couple pieces here in a little bit to show people what you've been doing. Let's take some ha-has. And let's see if let's get up into that high range with these, okay? All right.
Try that again.
Supporting it, that's why. Mm-hmm. You were supporting it and you were under it. What a beautiful voice you have, Vanessa. Let's do a couple more little runs and then we'll mess around with some tunes the way we always like to do. Okay. I like this one too. E-A-O. Right near that break and see if we can hear how beautifully you are handling that transition, because you do it well. Sometimes you're going, wait, no, I don't always do it well. I don't either. When I start doing my scales around the house, you know, and because I got a gig or something coming up, I'm ashamed at how sloppy that is, because you got to do it like every day. You have to do it every day, you know. So your break, you said, was B, natural?
Yes, around
there. All right, so let's go to an A. Let's go to an A. And the problem is, the picture that you have to picture is that sound now just totally moving right here. You know, feel it come right here when you're doing it. It's the same sound when we do nay, nay. Nay, nay. Do a nay for me there.
Nay.
There it is. You hear it? You can hear it, how bright it is all throughout here. So switching, let's slow it down a little. Let's see if we can get into that position. Well done. Well done. Beautifully demonstrated.
Beautiful.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. It's hard to come back to those chest tones. Let's demonstrate a little bit the difference in the sound of the registers, because this is something you and I have been working on quite a bit as far as, because the classical discipline does tend to keep your sound a little higher. And one of the things we worked on, especially for jazz, was getting some more just round chest sounds coming out. You know, the great Sarah Vaughan used those. It was just a part of her whole sound all the time, when she'd go down and use those beautiful notes. Because in jazz, we have options. Color with sound. And you're learning a lot about that. We're not just color with phrasing. We're going to work on something in a minute. Even though it's not exactly a jazz tune, but boy, we can demonstrate a lot with it. Let's take this, probably this E, this E4 right here, and let's try doing a E. Can you do a head tone in it? It's a little low, but I think you can.
Yeah.
Beautiful. It's got that rich woody sound. So beautiful. Beautiful. Now, let's do it. Do that note in your throat. Like just in your throat. Yeah, you were right. Beautiful. Now let's get the chest. So. Ooh, beautiful, beautiful. So how did you achieve that lower sound? What did you just do right now to achieve that?
I made like a yawn space in the back, so it's very open, and I dropped my larynx.
Drop your larynx.
Yeah.
That's always the key to it, dropping the larynx. That's the key to it, always. People ask how to do that. Well, you can feel it. You can feel your larynx moving up and down as you go from high to low notes. It's not, I mean, there's not a huge space for it to move up and down here, but it does make a difference in the tonal quality, moving the instrument lower to pick up sound from your ribs and your chest plate. Oh, you can really feel it. Do me a little yawny sound down into your chest there. No, I say I have a very low voice, so I can really get down there and sound like a tugboat. You sound beautiful, Vanessa. Why don't we mess around? Let's mess around with your tune a little bit.
Okay.
I picked a tune from West Side Story called Somewhere. I think the tune leaves a lot of opportunity, or creates a lot of opportunity for good phrasing and some improvisation. Did you ever hear the version that Aretha Franklin did of this?
Yes.
It's really something.
Yes.
She loves jazz, and she loves, you know, she loves to put her own stuff into the tunes, which of course is what all blues-based singers love doing, a little bit of themselves. But anyway, this tune, I thought for you, especially with your interest in theater, would be a nice addition to your show. And so we've been working on it. So let's play it. And you just get in there, and we'll stop and start just like we always do, and see what we got.
There's a place for us somewhere, a place for us, peace and quiet and all. For us somewhere, there's a time for us, someday a time for us, time together.
We discussed, which was one of my teachings is don't give it all away. You know, that is a huge dynamic lift when you get to the somewhere. That's a huge dynamic lift there. But we had already pre-discussed that save a little Don't hit them with the big notes right out of the box, you know? And just start adding to it as we go along. Is where were we in there? There's another verse, isn't there?
Yeah, there's one more.
There's one more verse. I would love to hear you get some, what are the notes
there?
Somewhere. I'd love to have you lower your larynx a little bit more and get a rounder sound. Can you practice that for me right now?
Somewhere.
Yeah, I think you can get even more. More.
Okay.
Where? All right, sing the whole phrase. Sing the whole line. Somewhere. Just that line. I'm sorry, just that phrase.
Somewhere.
That's beautiful, beautiful. I just want to give everybody an example of what we mean by we're going to give more on the end of this, you know, and really give this lift and this emotional and dynamic lift that happens at the end of this tune.
Hold my hand and I'll take you there somehow.
What I'm talking about.